What's up YouTube, Dark Populous here, and in this video I'm going to be showing you how to attach flags to vehicles in the ArmA free editor. So let's begin, shall we? Let's load up the editor, and the map we'll choose is Malden because it's nice and small and easy to navigate, like my penis. Okay, so now that we're in, let's go to the airfield so we can actually see what's going on. Nice and flat area. And let's put down some vehicles, because that's the objective, is put flags onto vehicles. So, let's put down a Hunter. Let's also put down a Prowler. And for more variety, let's put down a Strider. Okay, now I'm going to delete all of the personnel so the vehicles don't run amok driving all over the place, and I'm going to take myself out of the vehicle so we can see what's going on from the outside. Now, to attach a flag to a vehicle, you need to put the following inside the vehicle's init field. So to get access to the init field, you simply just double click on the vehicle in question. So we'll start with the Strider. Takes a minute to load, especially when you first start up the editor. Okay, so now that this pop-up's come up, you'll notice the init box here has the word init on it. And from here, you want to type in the following. You want to put in this to signify this is the vehicle you want this script to apply to. Force flag texture. And from here, you need to find the file path of the flag that you want to put onto the vehicle. So for this instance, we want to put the AAF Altis Armed Forces flag onto the Strider because the Strider belongs to the AAF. So in order to get the file path of the flags, there are two ways you can do it, but the most easiest way is to go to the community.bystudio.com/wiki page and look for flag textures. Luckily, I've kind of got it open in my other monitor here, so let me just bring up for you guys. There you go. I'll leave a link to this page in the description if you guys want to use it. And from here, let's go to the top. You want to scroll down until you find ArmA Free. I doubt the ArmA 2 and Operation Flashpoint and Operation Arrowhead file paths will work, so I wouldn't try that. But from here, once you reach the ArmA Free file path, you basically just want to copy and paste the file path in question. So as you can see, you got a selection from the United Kingdom, the United States, AAF, Altis, CSAT, FIA, and Altis Colonial, and a few more underneath that as well. So let's just highlight this, including the quotation marks as well, and you want to press Control C to copy. Go back into the game and paste that at the very end of our script here and press OK. And let's test that. Oh, come on. Dude, you're blocking the view with your hand here. Come on. So as you can clearly see, the physics still apply to the flag, so it will be flapping in the wind as you drive around. And there you go, that's how you attach a flag to a vehicle. So obviously, like I mentioned earlier, you can add all types of different flags to the vehicles. So for the sake of demonstration, let's add the US flag to one of the other vehicles. So you'll need this file path here where it says US_CO.PAA as opposed to AAF_CO.PA. And you basically just want to control C that file path and go back into the game. And from here, you want to type this again, force flag texture, and paste in that code. Press OK, and I should add the US flag to the Prowler. Now I'm going to add one more flag to the Hunter. And that's going to be the NATO one, which is underneath, under the various section here. So we want to copy this one where it says NATO and replace that like so. Press OK and let's test this. And voila. So most vehicles will have the flag at the very rear of the vehicle where the antenna pops out. But other vehicles, like the Hunter here, will have it in different locations. So as you can see, the antenna is actually at the front of the vehicle, so the flag will pop out there. And there you have it. So, while we're here, there's something else I want to demonstrate. You can actually attach this script to infantry and it will attach to the person that you put the code onto. So I'm going to put it onto myself so I can demonstrate this. Going third person. And we now have the NATO flag on the back of my character. So this is useful for like capture the flag scenarios, or maybe you just want to show this off to your friends, or maybe you want to roleplay like a bannerman or something. Not that there's something like that in the modern military, I don't think. Not in the middle of battle anyway. Kind of gives you away. But it's just really cool that they implemented this feature. But I'm guessing the primary purpose of this was for capture the flag. Or at least the game mode anyway in the multiplayer scenarios. So, yeah. There's that. You might have to add a trigger later to remove this flag from your person somehow. But that's for another video. Now, just something I never actually thought was possible. You can actually add this to air vehicles as well. So let's put down a Ghost Hawk. And we'll also put down a jet. If I can find out where it is. Planes, there it is. Let's put down the A-164 Wipeout. And let's get the US Army flag. Add it to the Ghost Hawk. Don't forget to delete all the personnel so it doesn't go flying around. And let's take a look. I still find it ridiculous that you can add this to helicopters as well. And the jet, oh my god, the jet's even more ridiculous. At first I thought this was limited to only ground vehicles, but the fact that you can add this to air vehicles as well, it's pretty funny. So I'm going to take off real quick just to show it's not going to blow up the helicopter or anything, you know, because armor. This gives me an idea for like a air show scenario, actually. Could just have like a formation of jets or like a fleet of helicopters flying over a park or something. With the flags attached to them. Give that air show feel. Okay, so there you have it. You can also add it to air vehicles. Now, at first as well, I thought this was only applicable to vanilla vehicles. So the vehicles only introduced in the base game. But apparently you can also add this to RHS vehicles, which is a mod. So I'm going to load that mod up real quick so we can demonstrate that. Okie dokie, now that we're back in the editor with RHS loaded, let's go ahead and put down some RHS vehicles. Doesn't really matter what, let's put down a Russian BMP, because I think BMPs are the coolest APC in the Russian army. And let's take myself out and remove the last of the guys inside the APC, so again it doesn't go driving around. And let's put in our script. Again, like last time, when you first load up the editor, it takes a minute for things to pop up. So this force flag texture, and we paste in the file path. I've accidentally copied the entire script. I don't know why I needed to put in this force flag texture in the first place. But anyway, you put this in, press OK, and let's see if this works, which it should. And voila. Whoop-hoo! Now, there is a slight dilemma. I didn't know how to get the file paths for the flags added by RHS, because obviously you don't want the US flag on a Russian vehicle. So in order to get the file path of the RHS flags, you need to actually go under the props section here at the top right, go down to signs, find the flags, and you want to find the flag that you want in question. So for this, it would be the Russian Federation. Put that down. Once you've got that down, you want to right click on the flag object in the editor and go to find in config viewer. Now it's a bit dodgy when this comes up, it doesn't actually take you to where the actual file path is. It just kind of puts you in the middle of this mess here. So you kind of want to scroll until you find what you need, which is going to be highlighted in white already for you since you went ahead and pressed find in config viewer in the editor. So once you find it, you want to double click on the highlight text so it opens it up. And some more text will appear underneath the white highlighted text. And you want to, instead of just scrolling through this block of text on the right side here, you want to go on the left and just click through all these subcategories until you find event handlers. And under here, it will say init this select zero set flag texture. And there's the file path that we need. Now, I'm going to copy this. And you'll know when it's copied because it'll flicker a little bit by pressing Ctrl C. And I'm going to open up a notepad real fast. I'm going to paste that in there. And then I'm going to delete everything except for the file path itself and the quotation marks, because you need the quotation marks for this to work. So you might have to add one at the beginning as well. So you want to copy the result. Close this out and go back into the init field of the vehicle that you want the flag attached to, and paste the file path at the end of the script here, and press OK. And let's test that. Glorious! Vasvidanya, comrade! Vasvidanya. Okay, so just to test this one more time, let's do this with another faction. Let's try the United Nations. Okay, so the United Nations are going to be under independent, and it's going to be generous UN peacekeepers. So let's bring out a BTR. Let's also bring out a UAZ. And let's bring out a Mi-24 high-end helicopter, because why not? Okay, let's delete all the personnel, because seeing as these guys are independent, they might shoot me for being up for, and we don't want that. So again, in order to find the file path of the flag, you need to right-click it and go to find in config viewer. And same as before, scroll down until you find the highlighted text, double click it, so it opens up and shows up all of this. And you want to go to event handlers and copy the code provided there and paste it into a notepad. Or you could post it into the init field of the vehicle, actually. Never thought of doing it like this, actually. This would have been a lot more simpler. You just paste it in there and delete everything except for the quotation marks. And then at the beginning of the code, type this, force flag texture, or space between, and press OK. And that should add the UN flag to the BTR. So we're going to add it to the other two vehicles as well, like so, and preview. Whoa, calm down there, calm down. So as you can clearly see, the flag's been added to the back of the hind, though it's clipping through the ground, but that won't be a problem once you're in the air. And the flag has also been added to the front of the UAZ. I kind of like how it's going up the side of the window screen here. Though there is the issue of the flag clipping through the roof of the vehicle as well, but yeah, small problems. And then there's the BTR, which is pretty much just perfect. It's just up in the wind, not clipping with anything. Gorgeous. So yeah, that's how you find the file path for the RHS flags and how you add them to RHS vehicles. So I hope you guys found this video useful. I know I found it useful trying to make this video. I learned a lot of new things, such as how to find the file paths of the flags and adding them to RHS vehicles, which I didn't think you could do in the first place. I thought you could only add them to vanilla vehicles, but apparently you can add them to modded content. Just a quick disclaimer though, I don't think it's going to work with every single modded vehicle. It may work with RHS, but I don't think it might work with vehicles from, let's say, Cup or other mods. So, quick disclaimer about that. So, I hope you guys, again, found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to rate the video, subscribe to the channel for more, and all that hokey pokey. I'm Dark Populous, guys, and you have an excellent day. Peace out.